So we have done basics of circuit analysis, whatever is required till now. Okay, now we'll talk about few rules. Okay, once you know these rules and whatever basic things which you have learned, once you combine all this, you'll be able to analyze any circuit. Okay, these rules are called Kirchhoff's rule. Write down. Have you learned this in class 10th already?
No.
So how do you know Kirchhoff?
Sir, we have to start with the
Only the definition.
Oh, you know it. Sir, even capacitor sounds, we know most of them they have used Kirchhoff.
Sir, in some numerical fields, last year.
So you know Kirchhoff?
I remember.
Okay, so now you should not leave because these are very, very straightforward, you know, rules. Write down. There are two rules. The first rule is Kirchhoff's junction rule. What is the junction?
Point where
two wires meet. Okay, can this wire have a junction?
Yes.
If you bend this wire like this, is there a junction here?
No.
There is no junction. Okay, you need what?
Two wires.
Two wires. One wire is here, one wire is there.
It's the same wire here.
No, I have taken two wires and joined them here. There is a junction? No, you need at least one more wire like this. Now there is a junction. Okay? I mean, this is what is junction in physics. Okay? You may disagree.
What?
Anyways. So draw this diagram first. There is a junction here, yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes. Is there a junction now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
So you can connect as many wires as possible at a single point. Okay? So suppose I connect only two wires, so you have four paths from which current can flow. Okay? So this rule is about what happens at the junction. Okay? So write down junction rule, the amount of current that is coming in the junction, the amount of current that is coming in the junction should be equal to the total current that is leaving the junction. Have you heard about this rule? So amount of current that is coming in the junction should be equal to amount of current that is leaving the junction. Isn't it straightforward?
Yeah.
Think it like as if water is flowing. So amount of water per second coming from here, if this two rows that is coming like this, these two rates should be like same flow rate should come out. Okay? So just think current as if water is flowing. It is plain and simple. So amount of charge per second coming here is current. So these two current, if they are coming in, let us say this is I1, write down, this is I2 and this is I3 and that is I4. So what is the relation between these three currents, four currents?
I1 plus I2 plus I4.
This is what current coming in. What is the current going out?
I3.
Fine. So I1 plus I2 plus I4 is equal to I3. Any doubt? No? Suppose it is situation is like this. I3 is coming in. Now what?
I2 plus I4
is equal to 0. There is no current that is going out. But is that possible?
No.
It is not possible. So what will happen?
One of them
will be negative. When you solve the equation, one or more will be negative. Okay? But when you are assuming direction of current, you don't know which direction the current is. As long as you are following the rules, you can assume anything.
Negative as in how, sir?
As in I1 may come out to be minus 2 ampere. That means that current is opposite 2 amperes.
So okay. We have to write it as I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4 is equal to 0 and one of them will be negative.
One or more. This is equal to 0. This is the amount of current that is coming in and that is the amount of current that is leaving the junction. Fine? So this is the junction rule. Okay? Now we'll take up Kirchhoff's loop rule. Write down. Kirchhoff's loop rule. Now this is Kirchhoff's loop rule. So where it will be applied? In a loop. Right? So there has to be a closed loop if you are applying Kirchhoff's loop rule. Okay? So it says that, write down, the algebraic sum of the algebraic sum of changes in potential, the algebraic sum of changes in potential, okay, around any closed loop involving resistance and cells is zero. Okay? You add all the changes in potential in the loop and you add all the changes, it will come out to be zero. Isn't it obvious? It's like this. It's like change in internal energy. If it is a loop, what happens? Change in energy here, you add everything and it will come out to the same point. Total change will be zero. Similarly here also. Resistance will change something, battery will change something, potential, and then when you come back to the same point, total change in potential will become zero. Are you getting it? Okay. We'll try to apply Kirchhoff's loop rule because unless you try it out, you'll not be able to understand what is going on. Okay.
So if the potential difference is zero, then how will the current
flow? Total potential difference in a loop is zero, algebraic sum. But even if there is a potential difference across a resistance, will there be a current?
Yeah.
Okay. Let us try to apply Kirchhoff's loop rule here. You have this R1. Okay. Let us say this is R1, capital R1. This is R2. This is R3. See, we'll not solve anything. We'll just write down the equation. Okay. Suppose this is I current coming here. I current comes here. What will happen to I current? Some current will go there. Let's say I1. Here I was there. How much current will go there?
I minus I1.
As soon as you say I minus I1, you have already used junction rule. Okay? So, see, amount of current coming inside the loop is what? Inside this junction is I. I1 goes away. So, how much is left? I minus I1. So, I minus I1 is there. So, you already used junction rule. Okay? You already used it. So, you can use junction rule on the circuit itself. You don't need to write the equation. Now, do one thing. Write down Kirchhoff's loop rule equation for this loop and that loop. Why I have drawn like this? Because when you are identifying the changes in potential, when you go from here to here, it will be plus. When you go from there to there, it is minus. So you need to specify which direction in the loop you are moving. So this is the specified direction I am moving, this is another specified. I am seeing there are two loops, but in fact there are another one, third loop also. But the third loop is a sum of this loop plus that loop. So the equation for the third loop is redundant.
So which is the first loop?
Okay, so do one thing, try to write down Kirchhoff's loop rule for this one and for that one. Okay, start from here for this loop and come back to this point only.
So
There is nothing loop 1 or loop 2. You can say this is loop 1 and this is loop 2.
There is one loop above and there is through R2 also one another loop.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you want me to do this one?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do this one for you. So suppose this is point number 1, all of you pay attention, this is point number 2, this is 3, this is 4, okay, this is 5, this is 6, this 7, okay. Now I am moving along this loop, the first loop. So what can I say? V2 minus V1 is what? V, is it correct?
Yes.
Okay, now is 2 equal to 3? Potential of 2 is equal to potential of 3? Right? So I can say that V2 minus V4 is what? V2 is V3, na? So V3 minus V4 is V2 minus V4. This is equal to IR1. Right? Now is 4, acha, 4, is this potential is same as 4 potential?
Yeah.
So V4 minus V6 is what?
I1,
R3. Okay, and is 6 equals to 7?
Yeah.
And 7 equals to 1?
Yes.
So I can write down this as 1. Okay, now when you add up.
Which one is this?
Is there any doubt? Any other doubt?
V.
See, I have just used this. Potential difference between this is V. Between these two points it is IR1, between these two points it is IR3, what else?
Sir, what? 5?
Yeah, sir, 5?
5, where is 5? See, I am not going in that loop. My loop is this only, I am going like this. I am not even going across R2. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
I am just taking this loop. R2 doesn't come in my path. Okay? Any other doubt?
No.
Okay.
But
now,
you can take R2 instead of R3 also.
Yeah, I can take it. I can take it. That becomes another loop. That's the second or third loop. Okay. Right now I'm talking about loop number 1.
Yeah. One loop will have only one.
Okay. Yeah, you take it. No, you get another equation.
This is, yeah.
Okay. Right now I'm taking only this loop, the lower one. Okay. Fine, now do one thing here, multiply this with minus, you get this, and that also minus, you get that, and after that when you add up, left hand side becomes 0. So this is V minus IR1 minus I1R3. This is what Kirchhoff's loop rule says. You could have directly written this. Sum of, this is algebraic sum of change in potential. When you move across a resistance, change in potential is negative. So when you go from here, what happens? Change in potential is plus V. So that is plus V. Then you move across a resistance. What is change in potential? Minus IR1. So V minus IR1. Then you go across R3. What is change in potential? Minus I1 R3. So there is anything else? No. So V minus IR1 minus I1R3 will be equal to 0. Are you getting it?
Yes,
so you don't need to write down these equations again and again. Okay, now try to write Kirchhoff's loop rule for this one, second loop. What will you write?
I1R3.
Is this minus or plus?
No, it's only x or plus.
You are going in loop like this, you are going like that, and current is flowing like this.
No,
so why? Sir, so why is it going like that?
Guys, pay attention here. I am traveling this loop like this, but current is going like that. Current is going in opposite direction. So which potential will be more, this potential or that potential? A or B? Whose potential will be more? A is more? A is more. It depends on the current. Right? So when you go like this, change in positive or negative? Change is positive. I am going from higher to, sorry, lower to higher potential. Right? So that is the reason why it will be plus I1R3. Fine. I am going from lower potential to higher potential. Okay? Now what? Guys, listen here. Now if you travel across R2, what will it be?
Minus I minus I1
times R2 equals to
zero.
So you have these two equations. When you solve it, you get the value of I and I1.
Sir,
directly.
Sir, V B will be lesser than V A, right?
Yeah.
So V B minus V A.
No, I'm not doing V B minus V A. I am going like this. I'm going like this, so I'm doing VA minus VB actually.
Okay. Because current is.
If current is going like this across a resistance, so potential will drop along the direction of current. Fine. So please write down few rules when you're writing changing potential. Write down. See, this will take some time for you to, you know, grasp properly. Write down few rules. When you're traveling along the direction of current, when you are traveling along the direction of current across the resistance, when you are traveling along the direction of current across the resistance, the change in potential will be minus I into R, where I is current and R is resistance. Fine? Isn't it? You have to choose a path the way you will travel the loop. Right? If you travel along the current across the resistance, the change in potential should be minus I into R. Fine? But if you are traveling against the direction of current, if you are traveling against the direction of current, then change in potential is plus IR. Fine? So these things just to remember. You should not be thinking too much on these small things. Okay? Just remember it. If you're moving along the direction of current across the resistance, change in potential is minus IR. But if you travel in opposite direction of current, change in potential is plus IR. Fine? And there will be battery also coming in between at times. Fine? So if you travel, if you travel from negative potential to positive potential, change is plus E.
Negative potential to positive potential,
change is plus E. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
Right? It doesn't matter what is the direction of current. Fine? But if you are traveling from positive potential to negative potential, change is
minus
E. Fine? So it doesn't matter what is the direction of current. Okay?
So if you're traveling the first circuit, the first loop number one, you travel through R1 along the direction of current.
Yeah.
Then change will be minus V.
Change is minus I into R1. That's what it is written. I into R1.
Okay.
Fine? So V minus I1 R1 minus I R1 minus I1
R3
is equal to 0. Fine? Now let us travel along this loop, the bigger one. You will have V minus IR1, then minus I minus I1 into R2 is equal to 0. Are you getting the hang of it?
Yeah.
Right? Any other doubt?
You can choose any direction, any loop.
Okay, but once you take these two loops, the third loop becomes redundant.
Yeah.
You will get sum of the two equations.
Yeah.
Fine? Any other doubt?
So if you move from 1 to 2, from the right direction.
1 to 2.
From the right.
From here to here, like this.
Yeah.
Then
it's against the direction of current.
Huh? No, it is in the direction of current only, first of all, I. But it doesn't matter, because you're going from negative potential to positive potential. So it should be plus V. It doesn't matter. When you're crossing the battery, direction of current doesn't matter.
Once you go to the top there.
Once I go to the top, I'm going along the direction of current. Here. I'm going like this. There. Yeah, I'm going against the direction of current. So it should be plus I1 into R3. Which equation?
The second one.
This one?
Yeah, the
second one.
This one?
No, sir.
Because
V2 minus
V4. Three equations here. Oh, this one?
That's V2 minus V4 is equal to
IR1.
Yeah. You are making.
Yeah, I multiplied minus. What is written is V4 minus V2 is minus IR1.
Sir,
yeah.
Tell me. If we are actually getting the sum of both the loops as one loop, why are you considering two different
loops? You have to consider at least two. Then only third becomes redundant. Don't write the third equation. That's what I'm telling you. Third equation is nothing but sum of these two equations. Okay? But anyways, you have only two variables, so why you need the third equation at all? Okay, so this requires a lot of practice. So we'll do that in next class. That's it for this particular class. Okay, so we'll continue with this chapter, do some questions on Kirchhoff's rules, and then we'll take up the experimental part of this chapter.